something a burglar would not want to see when he breaks into a house. Rob.
Naked grandma.
Naked, huh?
I don't want to see that either.
I know you're right, okay? Nobody wants to see a naked grandma, but what are the chances of you breaking in the house and running up into your grandmama naked? Just looking for a naked grandmama in the house, outside, in the woods, on the blanket. That's the occupant person that's there.
My name is Lexi, and I wanted to start baking for my boyfriend. Unfortunately, I don't know how to bake. So I'm taking this cooking class, and I'm not doing so well. So my instructor is sending over his star student, Sunny, to help me at my house. I'm a little concerned, see, because Sunny seems to have slutty lesbian tendencies.
Number 3, Back to the Future Trilogy. Marty McFly's adventures back and forward in time are banned in China, which claims time travel films disrespect history and treat it frivolously. The ban is thought to be enforced as the government don't want viewers to see characters escaping from the oppressive regime to a happier time or place. They also forbid movies that make up myths, have weird plots, and promote superstition.
Walmart is cutting back on some of its 24-hour locations, including a number of stores around the valley. The new hours will be 6 a.m. to midnight. Here's a list of local Walmarts affected by the change. A Walmart spokesperson tells Action News the shorter hours will allow the retail giant to reallocate its resources to provide better customer service during peak shopping hours. You can also check to see if your store is affected at KTNV.com.
Furries. The furry community is fascinated with anthropomorphic animals. Many furries adopt their own fursona for sexual roleplay with other human animals. Dressed in animal suits, they groom each other's fur and participate in orgies called fur piles. Lots of furries discovered their obsession as children when they got overexcited watching cartoon animals in Disney films. And some furries are even attracted to plush toys like teddy bears. Plushies collect cuddly toys obsessively, and some modify plush toys for sexual intercourse.
8. Pet Rock. When the Pet Rock hit shelves, creator Gary Dahl made $15 million in the first 6 months. The rocks came in a cardboard carry case with air holes in a bed of straw and included a manual about how to care for your new pet rock. Over 1.5 million people couldn't wait to snap up the rocks, ignoring the fact that rocks were widely available on the street for free. Costing $4 each, this useless invention was hailed as one of the most ridiculously successful marketing schemes ever.
Panda, and I'm at Walmart at 2 a.m. in the morning, and I got like the noisiest basket I could ever get. So yeah, bye.
What I seen was a horrible, tragic situation. The guy was coming down, and I guess the police was trying to do a stop point. The man said, no, not today, and they began to race behind each other like cats and dogs. The police officer got behind the man, and the police car just twisted around like a tornado, girl, and the Lord just shook it up, and the man just got injured. His head went to one side, and his body went to the other side, and girl, he hit the pole. And now the result is this police officer don't know if his life is going to continue to make it or he going to just tap out. Lord be with this young man. He need a blessing. I was actually going to buy me a piece of burger from Burger King, and I just stopped right in the middle because my hunger just went away. Because when I seen that accident, girl, I just began to be nosy, and I just had to just understand that somebody was experiencing this difficulty moment that was just not... Ma'am, I just cannot bear to continue to talk.
Oh, I...
Okay. Woo. Nope.
Yes, please. Okay.
And finally, in most of the US, it's illegal to possess a permanent marker or aerosol can in public if you are under the age of 18. So, if you ever took part in an arts and crafts day as a child, you're technically a hardened criminal. There was a controversial case in 2010 where a 13-year-old Oklahoma City boy was arrested for using a permanent marker in class. The teen was writing on a piece of paper using a permanent marker, and the ink had bled through onto the desk underneath. His teacher actually made a citizen's arrest on the kid, and he was handed over to the police and arrested.